Students, first year, assalamu alaikum. Our today's lesson is our poem Unit 3, Good Timber. Let's start reading the poem once and then we'll move on to the explanation. Now, Good Timber has been written by Douglas Mellage. He was born in 1877 and died in 1938. The tree that never had to fight for sun and sky and air and light, but stood out in the open plain and always got its share of rain, never became a forest again, but lived and died a scrubby thing. The man who never had to toil to gain and farm his patch of soil, who never had to win his share of sun and sky and light and air, never became a manly man, but lived and died as he began. Good timber does not grow with ease. The stronger wind, the stronger trees. The further sky, the greater length. The more the storm, the more the strength. The sun and cold by rain and snow. In trees and men, good timbers grow. Where thickest lies the forest growth, we find the patriarchs of both. And they hold counsel with the stars, whose broken branches show the scars of many winds and much of strife. This is the common law of life. Now moving on to the explanation. Stanza 1 is paraphrased here. The tree that did not struggle, which was necessary for living, but lived. It got all the things, food, water, air and light, easily, without any struggle. Additionally, due to its position in the open plain where it was standing, it always got enough rain. Those particular type of tree that didn't have to fight for what it had. Such kind of tree would never become a forest king, or are of the largest, strongest trees in the forest. It will live an ordinary and an unimportant life, like an unwanted thing, because it didn't add anything from its side for improvement in the already available things. Stanza 2, paraphrasing. The man who didn't struggle to get his own piece of land, which was necessary for living, but lived, he got all the things, food, water, air, light, without any struggle. He does not worry about resources and basic needs of life. Just like the tree was given all the elements of life it needed, so too was the man given his share without efforts. Those idle men who don't have to struggle for what they have to attain. He didn't add his share for improvement in the already available things. Such type of men would never become a disciplined and brave member of the society. He gains no name, but dies as he was born. He lives an ordinary life like trees. Stanza 3, paraphrasing. A tree that is going to live a large and successful life does not grow easily or without any effort. It has to face the difficulties to become a tree of good timber. It encounters with strong wind and strong trees. Those trees who already struggled and encountered with strong wind, it has to cover a long distance to reach its height. It has to face harsh and severe conditions of the environment, like more storm, uncertain amount of sun, cold, rain and snow. Good timber and men and manly men do not grow easily. The same forces forge both types of life. Stanza 4, paraphrasing. Both real men and good timber do not grow easily or in an easy environment. They live in the thickest part of the forest. They are both the leaders or the founders of their species. They are so high in their position that they talk with the stars, having deeper knowledge, wisdom, and commune with forces that others cannot understand. The broken branches and the scars of the tree and the man shows their tolerance and their ability to fight with harsh and severe weather. It also shows their long and successful struggle to attain their goals. This is the law of nature, that hard work is the key to success. Now, stanza 1, explanation, reference to the context. These lines have been taken from the poem Good Timber, written by an American poet, Douglas Mellage. The poet compares good men to good timber in his famous metaphorical poem. People, like trees, grow and reach their true potential by overcoming adversity. It is only through struggle, like a tree fighting through forest growth to reach the sun, that we grow and discover our true potential. Coddled and idle people do not live good life. They often attain death
as a scrubby thing, but real and brave people live and die like a manly man. It is common law of nature that nature has a supreme power which decides man's destiny. It is one of the inspirational poems and motivational poems with consistent and structured rhyme scheme of AABBCC to give long-lasting effect to the reader. The couplets give the poem a sing-song-like sound resembling a song lyric. Explanation 2. The poem brings with the speaker describing how there are two types of trees and men. He uses an extended metaphorical language to depict the similarities between men and other creatures of nature, like trees. In the very first sestet, he is talking about those particular type of trees which was given everything which it needed. It did not struggle for that which was necessary for living. It got all the things easily, for example, food, water, air and light. The poet says that additionally, due to its position in the open plain where it was standing, it always got enough rain. Those particular type of trees that don't have to fight for what it had, such kind of trees cannot become strong and enormous or famous. In the last two lines, the speaker reveals the outcome of such a life. Such kind of tree would never become a forest king or one of the largest and strangest trees in the forest. It will live an unimportant and ordinary life like a scrubby thing, unwanted thing, because it didn't add anything from its own side for improvement in the already available things. Next is explanation 2. The poet compares the tree to the man who lived a similar life like a tree. He didn't struggle to get his own piece of land which was necessary for living. He got all the things, food, water, air, light, without any struggle. He does not worry about resources and basic needs of life. Just like the tree was given all the elements of life it needed, so too was the man given his share without any effort. Those idle men who don't have to struggle to get success, he didn't add his share for improvement in the already available things. These idle men who lived a life without struggle and remained on the same position throughout their life. The last two lines reveal that the world be the outcome of such an idle man. He would never become a disciplined and brave member of the society. He would never become a leader. His position socially, morally and economically would not improve because he did not feel the need to reach beyond his readily available resources. He lived an ordinary life like the tree. Explanation 3. This sextet explains that good timber does not grow easily. A tree that is going to live a strong and successful life does not grow with ease. It has to face the difficulties to become a tree of good timber. It encounters with strong trees and its competitors, other strong trees, those who already had a strong and successful life, already struggled and encountered with strong wind. A tree of good timber has to cover a long distance to reach its height. It bears harsh and severe conditions of the environment, like more trees, uncertain amount of sun, cold, rain and snow. Good timber and good men don't grow easily. Explanation number 4. In the last sestet, the poet describes the environment of the man and good timber tree both grow in the thickest part of the forest. The poet tells us the importance of the tree of the first in the first stanza and the tree of the fourth stanza. The former given in an open plain and didn't add its share, but the latter grew away from sunlight and added its share. Such trees and men who struggle become the leaders and the founders of their species. They are so high in their position that they talk with the stars, having deeper knowledge and wisdom, and they communicate with forces that others cannot understand. They face the challenges of life. They handle the harsh and severe conditions of the environment. The broken branches and the scars of the tree and the man shows their tolerance and their ability to fight with natural forces. It also shares their long and successful life. This is the law of nature that struggle is necessary to live a meaningful life. Now, let's move on to question number 1. In the exercise, there are 8 questions. I'll start with the first one. What is the significance of the title of the poem, Good Timber? I'll read the answer. Reference to the context, this question has been taken from the poem, Good Timber, written by Douglas Mellage. The significance of the title of the poem, Good Timber, is that struggle is necessary to live a good and meaningful life. The poet presented two types of trees, and they are which fight for its survival and mentioned as good timber. The tree of good timber does not grow easily or without any struggle. Those who live through broken branches and storm will become good timber. Their broken branches and scars are evidence of their ability to survive and become the forest king. The poet also depicts similarities between trees and man. People, like trees, grow and reach their true potential by overcoming adversity. They live and die like a manly man. It reflects that through struggle, like a tree that is fighting through forest growth to reach the sun, that people grow and discover their true potential. Question number 2. What is good timber? How does tree grow into good timber? Reference to the context and then the explanation. It is the common law of nature that struggle is necessary to live a full and meaningful life. A good timber is one which fights from its birth to survive. It does not grow easily. Its broken branches and scars are evidence of its ability to survive and become the forest king. It has to face the difficulties to become a tree of good timber. It encounters with strong forces and strong wind. It bears harsh and severe conditions of the environment, like more storms, uncertain amount of sun, cold, rain and snow, to become a good tree or good timber. To live a strong and successful life, it covers a long distance to reach its height. Question 3. What, according to Douglas Mallett, is the fate of those people who do not work hard in life? Let's move on to the answer. After reference, we'll start the explanation. According to the poet Douglas Mallett, it is a common law of life that people who work hard in life live and die like a manly man, because struggle is necessary to live a meaningful life. Those who do not work hard, those coddled and idle people, do not live good life. They live an ordinary and unimportant life. Their position socially, morally and economically does not improve because they do not feel the need to reach beyond their readily available resources. They never become the leaders and the founders of their species. Such type of people cannot become strong and vigilant as they live a meaningless life. Question 4. How can a person achieve his or her true potential in life? Illustrated with examples from the poem Good Timber. After reference, explanation. A person can achieve his or her true potential in life through continuous struggle and hard work. He has to face the hardships and bitter realities of life. Then he is able to reach his true potential and struggle and strength. He passes through adversity, problems and obstacles to become a strong person. He fights from his birth to survive. He works hard for the basic needs of life and resources. He makes his position strong socially, morally and economically. As a good timber does not grow easily, similarly, a person cannot achieve his potential in life easily. People, like trees, grow and reach their true potential by overcoming adversity. It is only through struggle, like a tree fighting through forest growth and reach the sun, that people grow and discover their true potential. Now, question number 5. What is the central idea of the poem Good Timber? After reference, I'll give you the explanation. The central idea of the poem is that good timber and good men are formed through hardships and struggle. The poet compares good man to good timber in this famous metaphorical poem. People, like trees, grow and reach their true potential by overcoming adversity. It is only through struggle, like a tree or fighting through forest growth to reach the sun, that people grow and discover their true potential. Idle people do not live a good life. They often come to death as scrubby things, but real and brave people live and die like a manly man. It is the common law of nature that struggle is necessary to live a meaningful life. Question number 6 now. What is the rhyme scheme of the poem Good Timber? The rhyme scheme of the poem Good Timber is AABBCC. It is one of the inspirational poems with consistent and structured rhyme scheme of AABBCC. Question number 7. An extended metaphor is a poetic device in which two unlike things are compared in a series of lines of a poem. Give the examples of extended metaphor from poem Good Timber. Extended metaphor. An extended metaphor is a poetic device in which two unlike things are compared in a series of lines of the poem. Explanation and example. The poet uses an extended metaphorical language in his poem Good Timber, in which he depicts the similarities between men and other creatures of nature, like trees, there are two types of trees and men. First come those who get all the basic needs of life and resources easily. On the other hand, there are those trees and men who fight from their birth to survive. Question 8 now. What is alliteration? Give its examples from the poem Good Timber. After reference, you'll write explanation and heading of alliteration. Alliteration is the close repetition of initial identical consonant sounds, usually at the beginning of words, or any vowel sounds in successive or closely associated words or syllables. For example, 5 miles mean during with mazy motion, she sells seashells beside the seashore. In Good Timber, manly man, sun and sky, stronger wind, stronger trees, the more the storm, the more the strength, broken branches, etc. These are all alliteration. Now, how to paraphrase poetry is given on page 27 in your book. While paraphrasing the given lines of a poem, keep the following points in mind. Use your own words to explain the major ideas line by line. Paraphrasing isn't the same as explicating or analyzing a poem. The goal is to rephrase the ideas in your own words without evaluating or addressing the author's hidden messages or underlying themes. A paraphrase line of poetry is a literal translation in regular prose without rhyme or meter. Now, keeping in view the above guidelines of paraphrasing, write a paraphrase of the following lines. Where thickest lies the forest growth, we find the patriarch. So what we've done, all the paraphrasing. Read the poem Good Timber carefully and write a paragraph in retrospection about the feelings that the poem evoked in you. I've given you the explanation of each line. You can do this question yourself. Oral communication. Pick some students having good voice quality and range and ask them to read aloud the poem Good Timber with proper intonation and stress pattern. Now invite the class to comment on the message of the poem, the poet's use of language, imagery and tone. These are all classroom activities. Explain to the students different poetic techniques as studied in earlier grades. We've done this also. Let's move on to page number 28, which is the vocabulary. Consult a dictionary for the following words related to politics and then fill in the blanks with them. Words are electorate, parliament, majority, referendum, polling stations, policies, propaganda, to vote, ballot boxes, opinion polls, campaign ad. First sentence is, I would like to vote for your party, but I disagree with your politics on free trade. Number two, the election was thrown into chaos when two of the polling stations were destroyed in fires and several ballot boxes went missing at the close of voting. Number three, the opposition party won a large majority in the new parliament and the government accepted defeat. Number four, the government lost the election because it had lost the trust of the electorate after more than a decade in power. Number five, despite being more than 5% behind in the most of the latest opinion polls, we are still optimistic of winning the election next month. Number six, the Prime Minister was heavily criticized last month for giving the go-ahead to broadcast a campaign ad which personally attacked the leader of the opposition. Number seven, in the UK, any constitutional changes made by the government need to be approved in a referendum. Number eight, propaganda is usually used most frequently during a time of war as enemies use radio, TV, and newsprint to attack each other's actions and ideology. Now moving on to page number 29. Make possessive determiner or the possessive pronoun from the words in parentheses and then fill in the blanks. Number one, the bus stop is near our house. For we are going to use it, our. Number two, how is your new school? For you, I've changed it to your. Number three, this is my bag and that is his. He was given, but here his is being used. Number four, Sophia's hair is longer than mine. Number five, it's my turn now. Number six, the bike on the right is yours. Number seven, which desk is ours? Number eight, here are her tickets. Number nine, the children brushed their teeth. Number 10, our school is much nicer than theirs. Now exercise B, page 29. Fill in the blanks using the personal pronoun in brackets in its subject or object form or as a possessive determiner or a possessive pronoun. Now the first one, we can phone our grandma and ask her. Number 2, are they your friends? Number 3, she is working on her presentation. Number 4, excuse me, can I ask a question? Number 5, they can ride their skateboards. Number 6, he is his friend. Number 7, this is not my jacket, mine was blue. Number 8, she bought it for herself. Number 9, these two cats are ours. Number 10, they don't eat potatoes because they don't like them. Now moving on to the explanation of again the questions. The questions are a little difficult in this session. I'll give it to you in simple English also, so that if you want, you can write it yourself. First question is, what is the significance of the title of the poem Good Timber? The poet has beautifully used the title of the poem Good Timber to convey his message. The title itself shows the meanings and gives us a clear message compared with each other, aptly, as we know that both do not grow easily into becoming important and beneficial for the society. I'll explain further. The significance of the title of the poem Good Timber is that nothing can become good without suffering or confronting the hardships of life. The poet presented two types of trees, one which fights for survival, mentioned as good timber. Here, good timber also represents good and strong men who always fight for development because they want to become leaders of their species. Question number 2, what is good timber? How does the tree grow into good timber? Good timber is that which overcomes adversities and encounters stronger winds and unfavorable conditions throughout life. Then it becomes important, good and beneficial. When trees pass through sun, cold, hot weather, rain, snow, they grow and become good timber. Question 2 again. A good timber is one which fights from its birth to survive. Their broken branches show their ability for surviving in difficult conditions. A tree that encounters stronger wind, severe storm, heat of the sun, cold and rain throughout its life grows into good timber. Question 3 is, what according to Douglas Mallet is the fate of those people who do not work hard in life? Those people who do not work hard, they cannot develop their social, moral and economic position. They live and die without any improvement. According to the poet, the fate of those people who do not work hard in life, live and die without development. They never become the leaders of their species. Their position socially, morally and economically does not improve because they do not feel the need to reach beyond their readily available resources. Question 4. How can a person achieve his or her true potential in life? Illustrated with examples from the poem Good Timber. A person achieving his true potential in life, he can do that through struggle and encountering the hardships of life. The person who fights for survival can achieve his potentials in life. As a good timber does not grow with ease, similarly, a person cannot achieve his potentials in life easily. A person who bears adversity and conflict can achieve his potential. People like trees grow and reach their true potential by overcoming adversity. A person who can achieve his true potential by overcoming adversity, hard work, unfavorable and difficult situations in life polish us and make us good men and good human beings. If a person gets everything easily and without any effort, he cannot become good and a beneficial man. Such people live their life and die without gaining any improvement. The poet compares men with trees. Good tree is that which bears strong winds, rains and snow. Such is the case with men. Now question 5. What is the central idea of the poem Good Timber? The central idea of the poem is that good timber and good men are formed through hardship and struggle. Position and name cannot come without suffering, the adversities of nature or fate. The whole poem is an extended metaphor comparing trees to human beings. The central idea is that the struggle is necessary to live a full, beneficial and a perfect life. Now question 6. What is the rhyme scheme of the poem? Rhyme scheme is AA, BB and CC. Next is question 7. An extended metaphor is a poetic device in which two unlike things are compared in a series of lines of a poem. Give the example of extended metaphor from the poem Good Timber. The entire poem is an extended metaphor comparing trees with men. The poet says that people like trees grow and reach their true potential by facing and overcoming difficult situations in life. The poet compares trees to a man. First, he compares a tree with a man who does not struggle, and then he compares the other who suffers for survival. Question 8. What is alliteration? Give its examples from the poem Good Timber. Alliteration means the occurrence of same letter or sound at the beginning of consecutive words in a poetic line. There is alliteration in the second line, sun and sky, mainly men. Manly men, find the patriarchs and broken branches. Alliteration is a repetition of identical initial consonant sounds in a successive or closely associated syllable within a group of words. Alliteration is a figure of speech which is identified by the repeated sound of the first or the second letter in a series of words, or the repetition of the same letter sounds in stressed syllables of a phrase. In good timber, sun and sky, manly, man, good, grow, stronger wind, stronger trees. The more the storm, the more the strength, sun and snow, trees and timber and broken branches are all alliteration. Now I have explained the question answers to you twice. I have explained them in high-flung English, and I have also explained them in simple English for all those who have difficulty in understanding the language. There is no difficulty. Basically, the use of these high-flung words makes it a little difficult, but when you use simple words, it becomes very easy to understand, and then you will be able to write it yourself. Answer all the questions yourself. First and foremost thing is to understand the poem. This poem is about good men, hard-working men, and they are being compared to the men who never work hard in their life and get everything easily. But easy come, easy go. Whatever comes easy goes easily too. People who struggle are always remembered. Their struggles become their life, and their success is never forgotten. So anyone who works hard is always repaid. He gets what he deserves. This entire poem is full of encouragement for people who are hard workers. The poet is trying to tell us that people who work hard and survive, their survival and their life and their experiences become a lifelong story. They become legends with the help of the hard work that they did in life. People who never work hard, never strive in their life, and everything comes to them easy, live the life which is unknown. Nobody knows them. Nobody knows their struggles. Nobody knows their story, because they have not done anything. The tree who becomes the king of the forest is the one who has worked hard to attain sunlight, who has fought during storms, and has stood there strongly in the face of all types of adversities. The tree and good men are all compared to good timber. Good timber is the strongest. It is the strongest wood. It is describing those trees which have withstood all the problems, all the hardships, all the adversities in life, and have become what they are today. I hope you have understood the poem clearly. I hope you've understood the grammar part of the lesson also. It's easy. It's not difficult. First is fill in the blanks. The other is all possessive pronouns and determiners. I've explained it to you. I've given you all the answers. Please like and subscribe our channel, and do encourage us, and do tell us if you want anything else to be added to the explanation and to the videos. Thank you so much for your precious time. Hope you will subscribe to our channel. Thank you.